lot of people, they try to hide their neck because they have few cosmetic issues. They wear a high collared shirts, or the, sometimes they cover the, you know, like the ladies cover the neck with the hair, or sometimes they use the shawls to cover it because they don't want the cosmetic issues to be seen by others and commented by others. And there's a lot of treatment options are available for correcting the cosmetic deformities in the neck. We will start from the jaw as well as the neck so that it gives a complete picture here. See, the jaw, we are understand in females the jaws looks different, males the jaws looks different. So when you are trying to create a well-defined jaw, we need to be very clear about how the female jaw looks, how the male jaw looks, how, what is aesthetically pleasing for the females as well as for the males. See, males, we have a very strong and heavy jawbone and jaw angle also. So if you see the males, the jawbone from the chin, it goes like this. From here, it, you know, like vertically take off. So this will be a very, very much, you know, 90 degree from the jawbone to the mandible, which goes high. Females, it, you know, like it bends seamlessly like this. So when you're trying to create the mandibular angle, we need to understand this aesthetic point. And same way, it will be square shaped in males. Females, it should be oval shaped. So one more thing is, sometimes when the aging advances, the chin droops. So unless otherwise you give a chin good volume, it won't look aesthetically pleasing. Same way, when the age advances, this is called jowl fat. The jowl fat descends down. So because it descends down, there is a depression formed in between the jowl fat and the chin. It looks odd, as well as because of that jaw continuity won't be there. And when the age advances, some people, they started getting the necklines, we call it the platysmal bands. Platysmal bands meaning there is a muscle called platysma, and that's one particular areas it becomes thicker. So usually it between 2 lines to 4 6 lines 2 4 6, some people only 2 lines it forms. Some people, there is a, in the age advances, there is a fat prolapse here, so it looks very odd. And lot of people, they have horizontal necklines. Lot of people, they don't have a defined jawline. These are all the problems what normally we face in the neck regions. So we have to understand, the neck has a depressors. The platysma is a big depressor for the neck. See, when you block the platysma with the Botox injections, this line will be more defined, and that cheek looks, the whole face looks lifted up, especially this region. So now we will see each and every deformity in the cosmetic deformity in the neck and how we correct it. Horizontal necklines happens for various reasons. Even nowadays you can see it in the kids also. See, one of the reason usually postulated is, like, when you keep seeing the mobile like this continuously, what happens, you keep flexing the neck so that the lines form permanently. So sometimes you don't aesthetically pleasing, it don't give aesthetically pleasing neck. So we need to address the horizontal necklines. What are the options for the horizontal necklines? Okay, even when we do a facelift surgery, though we raise the whole, skin from the underlying muscles, sometimes this horizontal necklines are very difficult to eradicate. So there is a non-surgical option for the horizontal necklines. What usually we do is, we inject a Botox in the neckline itself, and after a week we'll call them back and we fill that necklines with the very soft fillers so that it merges with the skin. The necklines will be very much less prominent because of the fillers here and the Botox. So the filler stays there for 1 year and Botox stays there for 6 months, 4 months to 6 months. So you might need a top up. So the horizontal necklines will be very much managed with the fillers and Botox sometimes lipolytic injections to reduce the fat in that region, or sometimes the radio frequency and ultrasound based machines are there. So first we address the fat in this region, then we address the lines by giving a Botox and fillers. So these are all the options for the horizontal necklines. So though it's temporary, it definitely, the people who are really bothering about this, you have the option for this. Second, we are going to discuss about the angle of the mandible and the defined jawline. Okay. So what are the options available to make the jawline more defined? Okay. Major thing is the filler and the Botox. I'm telling about the non-surgical options. So when you have a discontinuous the jawline, where are the discontinuity happens usually? There will be a dip here because this fat droops. There will be a dip here, and this is obtruded by the excess kind of a skin goes like this. So there won't be a defined jawline here because the neck depressors are acting more. So for that, what we need to do is, there is something called nefertiti lift. First, what we do is we inject Botox in the platysma here. Platysma is a muscle name, which is that depresses the neck from the upper face. So we inject the Botox here, then we chase the platysmal band here. One platysmal band goes like this. How will you identify this? You have to put the outer part of the lip downward and outward. If you do like that, the neck muscles get contracted, and you can see the platysmal band here and the tight neck here. See, when you tighten the platysma muscle by putting your outer lip downward and outward, you can see this border become less evident, and you are the ideal candidate for the Nefertiti lift. Nefertiti is a queen name, Egyptian queen name, who has a very defined jawline. So we put Botox here. See, Botox stays there for 4 months to 6 months, but sometimes it even prolonged for some reason, we don't know. Even not last yesterday I did a patient who said that it almost stays there for 9 months to 1 year. So it differ from patient to patient, but usually it stays in 4 to 6 months. If you want to make this jawline more defined, Nefertiti lift will be a good choice. Then comes the here there will be a discontinuity between the chin and the jowl fat, because jowl fat comes down, so it makes a prominent. Usually what we have to do is, ideally we have to first lift the jowl fat by giving the filler injection in this region, so that usually there is a lot of ligaments which pulls the face up because of the laxity of the ligament, this sags. So first we inject the filler here so that it lifts up, so this jowl become less prominent. Then you assess how much you need to fill the gap here. So usually volume of filler, any strong filler is good. So this filler we inject it here, and most of the time even the age advances, chin also droops. The age advances meaning a lot of people, when they lose weight, also chin droops. So giving a stronger chin here as well as filling this gap make the jawline continuous, and giving the Nefertiti lift here. Sometimes if female, they don't want a bulky masseter muscle here. There is a muscle called masseter which makes it, this area goes bigger, So if you make the masseter goes down by giving a Botox and Nefertiti lift and the fillers, all this together, you can say that you can make the jawline looks prominent and chiseled. All are non-surgical. Definitely it works and it gives a very good results. But selecting the candidate is very important. If you have a lot of fat in the neck, obviously doing this procedure is not going to be helpful. So you have to understand all those things, so that when you wanting to know about your neck problems, definitely these things will help, and you meet a plastic surgeon nearby, they'll definitely guide you more. See, in some people, the platysmal bands, what is platysmal bands? The thick band like structures run from the neck lower down to the neck. Basically, this is a muscle called platysma, which becomes thickened in few areas. Usually, start with 2, sometimes 4, sometimes 6 lines will be there. So each lines can be addressed very well by surgically as well as non-surgically. I am going to discuss about the non-surgical options. Non-surgical options, best option is the Botox injection for the platysmal band area. Each platysmal band is injected with 12 units of Botox in multiple sites, and this Botox injection makes it very less prominent, so that your neck look aesthetically more pleasing. So sometimes 12 means one band 12 unit means 2 band 24 units. If you go for a 6 bands, it will be more. So you have to understand how to correct the platysmal bands by non-surgically using the Botox. Double chin. How will you correct the double chin? Double chin happens for various reasons. The fat accumulation in between the muscle and the skin. Okay, sometimes fat will be accumulated below the muscle. We have to identify which plane it is first. And second thing, sometimes the gland called submandibular salivary gland here, that prolapse and comes down. You should not, you should confuse the submandibular salivary gland with the fat. Sometimes what happens if you are wanting to correct the fat deposits here, we do liposuction if it is between the muscle and the skin. You should not go and suck the submandibular salivary gland if there is a prolapse. Sometimes some other muscles called digastric and few other muscle bellies will be bulkier. Sometimes we need to trim the muscles to make it smaller by, like surgically when you are doing it. So options for the double chin. We normally make a small nick here and do the suction, liposuction here, and we make a small nick in the below the ear and do the liposuction in this area also, so that neck look more defined. You have to understand, when there is a fat between the skin and the muscle, this liposuction will help. When you try to tighten the muscle in this neck region, if the swelling becomes less prominent, the fat deposit here become less prominent, that means that fat is below the muscle. For that, definitely liposuction won't be the helpful choice. Liposuction might be added to this. So what we need to do is, we may need to make a cut here in the chin crease region. So usually this cut won't be visible at all. So we go down, go below the muscle, remove the fat globules here, that region, then only it becomes less prominent. Most of the time, when the platysma is the muscle which covers here, when the fat is subplatysmal plane, along with that, usually most of the time the chin also droops. So correcting the removing the fat alone won't be the good thing. You have to keep a chin implant here to make the chin more prominent, so that this looks even though fat goes down, if the chin droops, that it won't be aesthetically pleasing. So we have to correct that also. Sometimes we do the fillers here, sometimes we do the lipolytic injection there to reduce the fat if you do non-surgically. But I prefer for the subplatysmal fat deposit, the open surgical reduction as well as the chin implant will be the better choice than going for a lipolytic injections and the fillers here. Sometimes it works, but the stronger looking the chin as well as the complete removal of the fat only happens by our open removal. If you understand that, we can easily correct your double chin and make you happy. Meet your nearby plastic surgeons and clear your queries, and they definitely help you to get rid of your double chin. What is neck lift? Usually the neck lift is combined with the facelift. A lot of people, they ask isolated neck lift, but extremely rare. Usually the neck lift also combine the cut here. If you want only the neck lift, probably we need not go up all the way up here. So only we go down in this region and raise the whole flap, and we have to tighten the muscle here, platysmal muscle here. Along with the platysmal muscle tightening in the sides, as well as we make a small cut here, we'll see the platysma in the middle, and tighten it in the midline also. So both the things only gives a good results. When you're doing tightening, we always remove the fat in this region, so that this will go, that angle becomes very clean and neat. And sometimes along with it, we put a chin implant also, because most of the time aging process, chin also droops. So making a cut here, going down and pulling it up, by tightening the platysma muscle as well as removing the excess skin, and tighten the muscle in the middle also and remove the excess fat. And sometimes if the we need to redrape a lot, we need to dissect, so up to the, you know, like the jawbone, sorry, the collarbone, so that the skin will comes nicely and redrape. This is called neck lift actually. So don't say think that neck lift means only we address here, so no cut will come in this area. Definitely there is a small cut here also. Sometimes isolated cases, you know, like only this bands are more prominent as well as the fat here, we make a cut only here. It depends on patient to patient. So the surgical neck lift only carries all those things.